Father, we once again give you all the praise. We thank you for adding another day, another hour, another minute, another second into our lives. This morning, we are inviting your spirit to come and take control. If there is anything demons, wizards, witches are operating against our service, against our lives, against our future, against our plans, against our destiny, oh, our Heavenly Father, we come against that thing in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
We invite the Spirit of God to come and take control. Lord Jesus, we give all the praise in the name of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Spirit that we pray. Let's say amen.
Amen.
Beloved, today I'm going to talk about 10 ways that can transform your life to success. And also 10 attitudes that can hinder your prayer life. At times people do ask questions, why me? Why me? Beloved, before you ask that question, you need to assess your life. Our thinking can become a hinder into our prayers. Our imaginations can also become a hinder into our prayers. So we need to be very sensitive to the Spirit of God. God called you for a purpose. I say God called you for a purpose. God did not call anyone to disgrace him or put him to shame. But he called us for a purpose. God called us for an assignment. Some of us, we don't know the purpose of our calling. At times, I keep on saying, if you're in the house of God and there's nothing that you are doing, it is not necessary for you to come to church. If you're a pastor, you are not doing nothing.
So, if
you're a pastor's wife, you're not doing nothing. If you're a singer, you're not doing nothing.
So, David
said something.
David,
he said, it should be good, it should be nice, and it's my responsibility to be in the house of God every day.
David said, yeah, I'm a friend, I'm a friend.
He is in the house of God doing what? We need to come to the house of God to come and fulfill our promises. To come and fulfill our responsibilities. Some of you, we force you before you do something for God. Some of us, we call you before you do something for God. Some of us, we don't take God's business serious. And some of us, we want God to take our business serious. We don't take the family of Christ
serious.
We don't protect the family of Christ. But we want God to protect our families. We want God to protect our business. We want God to protect our case. Whatever that you want God to do for you, first do it for Christ. And your life will not be the same. When was the last time somebody invited or somebody called you for a counseling? When was the last time somebody seek an advice from you? Can you tell me, as a pastor's wife, somebody came to you for a good advice? You were a pastor, somebody came to you for an advice. You were a church member, somebody came to you for an advice. And even if they came for advice, was it successful to them? And what kind of advice you gave to them? We need to change our lifestyle. We need to transform our lives. Success is possible. Success is possible. God called us for successful life. And our purpose of calling is to become success. Now it's like the unbelievers are being succeed. But Christians are complaining. They are serious doing their businesses. unbelievers seriously doing their businesses. They are being faithful to their business partners. But so-called a Christian, you are not faithful to yourself. You are not faithful to your Christian brother. You are not faithful to your Christian sister. Some of you don't even talk because of what somebody did to you. Can you try as much as possible? You will love for what do you call it? Forgetting be part of you. Let the bargain be bargain. Being a problem to somebody's life can hinder your prayer. So you pray but you don't get any results. You pray but there's no any positive change. But the more you pray, the more demons play about you. Why? You need to change your lifestyle. I want somebody to write this positive thing down. There's something as a believer you always need to remember. I said there's something you need to remember. This thing, if you are able to do it or if you are able to stay away from it, it will help you. Always remember that you can grow without destroying others. That is point number one. If you want your prayer to be answered, remember that you can grow without destroying others. Some of you think destroying others is what can make you grow. What's happening about others will make you grow? Destroying others will make you grow. Destroying others to their husbands, to their wives, to their family members will make you grow. No. It can never add any value to your life. Destroying somebody is a curse. So your prayers are not answered because you like destroying others. And whatever that you do, if you destroy others, God will allow people to destroy you. So stop destroying others. Tell the one sitting beside you, stop destroying others so that your prayer can be answered. Can I hear a clap here? Point number two. If you want to be success, if you want to be transformed, if you don't want your prayer to be hindered, always remember that your dream can be fulfilled without sabotaging others. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Your dreams can be fulfilled without sabotaging others. Some of you think sabotaging others can make your dreams to fulfill. It is totally wrong. Learn to encourage others. Say good things about people that you hate. Love people that you hate. Jesus said something.
He said,
we should pray for our enemies. Your enemy can only change whereby you begin to pray for that person. You always curse them. You always curse them. You always curse them. But you forgot that you are even under a curse. When you are not wearing a right shoe, don't make any attempt to curse. If you hate your sister, if you hate your brother, and you are praying to curse somebody, you are rather inviting curses upon your life. Stop sabotaging others. Stop set up others. Stop gossiping others. Stop thinking negative about others. Because whatever that you sow, you reap it. Point number three. Always remember that nobody must go down for you to rise. At a moment when we press people down, when we destroy others, when we condemn others, when we dismantle others, that is what can raise up. But it is wrong. Am I preaching a sensible message? Be very careful. Don't press people down. I was saying something this morning. Some Christians, they find it difficult to lift up their other fellow. When we're doing something, when we're working, when we're doing something, when you want to create something, you will find it difficult for them to support you. What is going on? We hate each other. We don't support each other. What is going on? Last, I was asking myself a question. If you go to church groups, at times I feel very sad. You can test the message. You can say something. But the people that you are expecting to make a comment, people that you are expecting just to say amen, people that you are just saying to just show up, they don't make any move. They don't say anything. Is there anything going on that I don't know? Is there anything going on that we don't know? Beloved, let us love each other. Let us love each other. Let us love each other. Because love is a weapon. I tend to ask myself a question. Who a leader of group will never even make a comment. But when you go to people's churches and we see unity and we see love and we see communication, we forget our wickedness. But when it comes to church, we want to compare our churches to sensible people's church. Sensible people's church. When was the last time you make a comment? When was the last time you call somebody and tell the person, I just want to check on you? We always want to create unity and love. But some of you always create misunderstanding, confusion, trouble, problems. Before you make any call, think about it before you make that call. What did you say? What answer did you give to the people who are calling you? Beloved, we need to be very smart. At times when people come to me and say, Papa, when I went to this church, this is what they were doing. I ask myself, and I speak to myself, that if you are in that church, if you are in that church, that church can never do that. We need to transform. We need to change. We need to change. Change your lifestyle. And your life will not be the same. Change your lifestyle. And you become success. Change your lifestyle. And God will bless you. Change your lifestyle. And you can get married. Change your lifestyle. And you can travel. Change your lifestyle. And people will love you. Change your lifestyle. You'll get money. Change your lifestyle. People can work with you. Change your lifestyle. And people will talk good about you.
Yes, sir. I'm proud of you. You have a in some part of your home. Amen. Yeah, I some money.
What did you say about your friend?
Yeah, I can follow down for him.
When the demons are using you,
sir, I'm some 40 years, Juma.
When the spirit of confusion is using you,
sir, my team, my cow, and we.
You see yourself as you know your rights. Till you change. But you know one funny thing about Christians? We pretend to be genuine. Me standing here, I'm not perfect. I'm human. I always pray for God to shape me. I was asking somebody 3 days ago. That can you please advise me? What do you think it is the good thing for me to do? Is there anything that you think if I do, it can help me? And what a person told me, I prayed about it, and I asked the Holy Spirit to direct me so that I can fulfill my promise to God. When was the last time you go to somebody and ask the person to advise you? We don't laugh.
You're not.
If you heard what somebody have said about you, if you heard what somebody is talking about you, if you know what people are planning against you, if you know what people are imagining about you, you start praying. Never think if you press somebody's down, you can rise. Amen.
Amen.
So stop pressing people down. And there's another thing that I've noticed. At times when people want to smile, he wants somebody to fall down before he smiles. Always remember that nobody must be shamed or embarrassed for you to smile or to sustain. And do you know some Christians, that's what they think. That's what they want. He wants you to put to shame so that they can laugh. They want you to put to shame so that they can smile. Anyone who wants to put you to shame, may God put that person to shame. Don't think that way. And there are people too who are so good. When they see you mistaken, they call you, they advise you, they warn you, they direct you. May God bless anyone who is directing you. Whoever is praying for you to change, may God bless that person. Whoever is advising you to change, may God bless that person. But whoever wants you to put to shame before he or she will smile, may God curse that person. Point number four. Point number five, right? Always remember that while others are rising, you can also rise. If you help people to rise, you can also rise. Do you know what I'm saying? Let me tell you something here. When Bobo is on his knees, and I want to lift him up, I am rising him, and automatically I also come up. True or false? Go down. I'm also down. So when I'm lifting him, I also come. So try to lift others than pressing them down. Last week when I was preaching, I said something. Every day, make sure somebody will mention your name and say good things about
you.
One of the last time somebody picked something and said, this thing was given to me by this person. When was the last time somebody mentioned a name and said, without this person, I could have been a human? But whenever people mention your name, they cry. They cried. When they mention your name, they become worried. When they see you, they become disturbed. What do you think it is coming to you? What do you think it is pursuing you? What do you think it is pursuing you? What do you think it is chasing you? Curse is locating you. So change. When was the last time somebody mentions your name?
Dabena Obibodi.
When you see people making it, when you see people pursuing, when you see people with a talent, support them, guide them, train them. When you see people suffering, put yourself into their suffering. Don't be selfish. Some of you, you will think when you're abroad, you are okay.
Say, according to your mind,
when we're in the US, you are okay.
Say, America, you are okay.
When we're in Canada, you are okay.
Say, Canada, you are okay.
When we're in the UK, you are okay.
Say, English, you are okay.
Do you know where that can make you happy? Do you know what can make you okay? To make okay is to be in Christ. Because with God, all things are possible. Something is going on spiritually. And God, like the song that the Esther Mwako song. He said he can read far than you think. Somebody rejected me 3 years ago. That person was a so tight and very good friend to me. He even bought me a car.
Oto car mami.
It was just a gift to me.
What did he tell me?
When I was in Canada.
Na mo Canada.
He said, "Take this car. Your kids can use it to go to school."
Blah blah. When I saw car, he tell me, "Say me mabe tumi diako school."
Do you know what happened?
Unim diyesiye.
When Christianity burnout started in my life. Christianity burnouts. When it started, when people are running away from me, I didn't hear from this lady. But I come, I was in Canada, and she came to me and reported that doctor said her kid will die in the next 6 months.
Doctor, obe catch me Canada, obe catch me. Say, doctor say.
And I said, it will never happen. When we're dealing with anybody who have lifted you up before, somebody who have blessed you before, somebody who have laid hand on you before, be very careful. When we're saying something about that person, be very careful. When you are destroying that person, be very careful. Because whatever that you do to that person, it will come back to you. This one, when I wake up, I saw a text message. So I was absent. Was it a wrong message from that person or what? And the message was just saying, "Good afternoon, Papa." So when I look at the message, it was yesterday's message. So I respond and say, "Good morning."
It means me respond and say, "Good morning."
Do you know one funny thing about me? I have the spirit of forgiveness. So when I responded the
message,
she replied,
"Say
it's long time."
Say,
and I said, "Yes, by the grace of God, I'm still alive." And she typed, Do you know what happened? When the doctor said the child will die in the 6 months' time, but in abroad, before they will tell you that your child or you will die, meaning they have about 90% proof that you can die. So I pray for the child, and they said they are going to do an operation. But for the child to survive, it's just 30%. But for the child to die, it's 70%. So they were afraid to do the surgery. So when I prayed to God, and I said, God, don't put me to shame. So we went to the hospital. God is my witness. I slept the
hospital.
I slept the hospital. I prayed for the child. 6 good days. Now the child is alive. When my former wife called them and told them I'm not from God, they believed it. That is what makes me so sad. I'm not from God, but I was able to pray to God. You know, human are ungrateful. Whenever you do good to somebody, if you have a receipt, I would advise you to write it down. 3 good years.
If you mean such,
but do you know something about me? I don't blame people who offended me. Do you know the reason why? They don't know what they are doing. I even showed the message to somebody this morning. And she said, Papa, we are coming to Ghana for a funeral. My husband, dad is dead. My mother, grandmother also is dead. We are coming to Ghana for almost 25 years. I haven't been to Ghana before. So we are coming. Please, we need your prayers and your support.
No, Captain, I said, we could do Papa, we should be Nana, it's your back, Anna. Abaya, you know, Bompire, am I?
And if I come, I will visit your church. I have it on my phone right now. But if she comes, I will make sure I will remember her. Do you know something about pastors? At times, we cried a lot. Do you know what happened to me yesterday? My brother is in hospital. And since Monday, it was Monday that you took him to hospital. Tomorrow is 1 week. I spent almost 2,300 Ghana cedis. $22 million. I have spent more than $22 million. We have already spent more than. Is it for? No. We have spent more than $80 million here at Apatrapa. Yesterday when I was going, I didn't have any money on me.
I left
with just 1 million.
Now come in, million.
So when I went there, my brother-in-law was the one who was taking care of him. And he said, we need to go and buy another medicine. Because he's very hyper.
Now, why?
So, I just look into the air. And say, God, don't put me to shame. So I just gave that 100 cedis to them. And I said, I don't have any money. You know, I am the one who have paid all the bills. So when I came outside, my car was parking there. And I wept. Because yesterday was a bad day in my life. Yesterday was a saddest day in my life. When I was weeping, I wanted to go to Nanama. I was wearing just a shorts. And I don't have money. My petrol, what do you call it? My fuel also was down. So I called your daughter. I say, sweetheart, can you please send me 50 Ghana cedis? Because, do you know something? I needed a fuel. And my daughter said, Daddy, I don't have money, but I think I have 130 Ghana. So please, can I send it to you? When my daughter sent that money to me, I wept. I was just asking for 50 Ghana cedis just to buy a gas.
Now me pay 50 cedis. Eddie a top petrol. So I'm going to send 130 cedis.
So I parked my car.
It's me saying parking car name.
I was in my car crying.
Now me take me car name.
And boss also came.
Now boss also so bad in
change. He said, "Daddy, is everything okay?"
No, beside me say, "Bibi, I'm okay."
And I said, "Yeah, I'm very okay."
Now me can't say I me win.
Do you know something? Life is a full of challenge. So when the bad or the darkness time comes, remember your God. I was parking in front of Nanama. I can even go there. But and I know when I don't have money, I just go and I send me money. 500, 200, 300. Even if I ask her to send money and she delays, I just I don't want to work with poor people. I need money to send it right now. He said, yeah, she will pack and send it to me. My 500, my 5 million or my 3 million or my 2 million, I will never mix it.
My 5 million and 3 million, they can't mommy.
But what I was going through yesterday, I feel shy to see my daughter. Because I was so annoyed. I was so sad. I was asking myself, why? So I parked the car for almost 30 minutes. Because when I was driving, I was shaking. When I saw my brother lying down and the way he is reacting, and they needed just 300 Ghana cedis. That time I don't have that money. But there's something about life. Whatever that happens to you, there's a hand of God in it. And I will never say any good thing about my God, I'm serving him. I won't say anything bad about my God, I'm serving him. You know, God loves you. And with that such things, you can't share testimony. So when I came here, Dorothy can be my witness. Her mom can be my witness. Sita can be my witness. I was in my car. Very quiet. Asking God why. By the answer God gave to me is to pray. Because prayer answers all things. So I pray to God. When you see hardship, meaning there is a soft somewhere waiting for your life.
Yes. Casa, 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 Casa,
thank you, Jesus. I called about two church members, went there to go to them.
And I'm afraid as for mom, you know, I'm person to call on chain.
But there was a question I was asking myself. When they see me crying, what would they think? So I was hiding myself. You believe it.
Unji endi.
I was down.
Na me bam ebupa.
Dorothy mom came to me and said, "Papa, won't you have a seat?"
Dorothy mami ba me che me catch me said, "Eja won't na se."
I said no.
Na me ka said bi.
I was just looking at the bush.
Na me de mani a che kwaye a etawi.
Asking God.
Ebusa Ewurade se.
God, where is my God?
Na Ewurade mi nyankopon ewe.
Yesterday I was hiding myself. You know, at times life can be a war to fight you. If I tell you yesterday, there wasn't even just a Peswa in my mobile money, you
wouldn't
believe it. When I was leaving the house, Kwaku, who gave me money?
Kwaku, and a mamiska.
It was 100 Ghana cedis. No, 10 Ghana cedis.
No, yeah, 10 Ghana cedis.
And he said, I opened my, what do you call it? Yes, my money box. And this is what I found inside, so that he take it. That is the expectation of your enemy. That is the expectation of your enemy. Your enemy always wants you to be down. Your enemy always wants you to cry. But if God was able to allow my son to give me a money, and I was able to take that money to town, and my daughter also gave me money, meaning my God is a God of providers. He is a God of provision. So I want to encourage you this morning. Think positive. No matter what you are passing through, think positive. Last point. Allow the true fear of God to guide your days. Strengthen your relationships and set on your course. Always allow the true fear of God to guide you. If you allow the true fear of God to guide your steps, you will never be put to shame. And God will always protect you. God, Richie, bless you this morning. I don't know what you are passing through. I don't know what people are doing to you. Your family can reject you. Your friends can reject you. Your mother can reject you. Your dad can reject you. Even your pastors can reject you. Your church members can reject you. But if a human rejects you, meaning God needs you. It means God needs you. So this lady I was talking about, the lady that I was talking about in Canada, I prayed for the child. I spent 6 days at the hospital. And when, after the operation, the doctor said, it is a miracle. Upon all this, she left. But along the line, I heard a message from somebody. The person said, this is what Gifty said.